Hello, my name is Achit and in this video I will demonstrate how to mount a network drive for Synology AD users. So let's start with the configuration. First of all, you need to log into the Synology with the administrator username and password. So once you log in with the username and password, we need to go to main menu. Under the main menu, we need to go to Active Directory Servers. Under Active Directory Services, we need to go to User and Computers. And I will create a new user for which we need to map a network drive. So click on add, click on user. I will create a user with the name of Harry. So description is HR team. Email, you can give any email ID. I'll just give my email ID. Password. I'll select the option password never expires. Click next. So you make sure your user is a part of a domain admin group. Check that box, next, and apply. So till the time user creation is going on, let's go to the control panel and check which folder I need to share for the particular user. So you can see under the share folder, I have a folder name called data, which is under the volume 1. So I want that once the user is logged in, if he's logged in on the first time, he's logged in after time, he's logged in after 10 days, once he logs in, the network drive will automatically share on his computer. So what I'll do, after the user creation, I need to give the permission on this particular directory. So I click on edit. I select the data folder, I click on edit. I'll go to the permissions. Under the permission tab, we can see you have a local user. I will go to the drop menu and select the domain users. So once you click on the domain users, all the domain users which you have created will list under this window. So you can see, so the username called is Harry. So I want to give Harry a read and write permission. So if I want to give a custom permission, I will go and click on custom. So you can see the custom permissions here. So if you want that user can also administrate the particular folder, so you can click on checkbox or press OK. So I will just leave as a default, close, close. So I'm using a read write permissions, press OK. So once you have given the permissions, now you need to go to the users. Under user, go to the properties, click on edit. Under the edit, you need to click on profile tab. Under the profile tab, you can see the category called a home directory. We need to select a connect. Drive name should be G and path of the folder backslash 192.168.50.137. This is the IP address of the Synology slash data, which folder I want to share. You can see the folder name is data. Press OK. Now the permission is given. So let's log in to the client machine with the username called Harry. So I have a machine installed on my VirtualBox. The IP address of the machine is 192.168.50.134. I log in with the username called Harry. Password. So now need to accept the certificate. So now user will log into the domain server using thinkit.local domain. I think the password, we have put the wrong password. So now you can see Harry user is logged into the ThinkIT domain. Now we are logged into the machine. Let's go to the My Computer. So you can see data folder which is shared on the Synology box is automatically mapped. So we'll click on that. So you can see all the files which are under the data folder is displaying here. So this user can create any file or any folder under this data folder. So this is the way you can map or mount a network drive for the AD users. So thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe.